Hello everyone, Dr. Polaris here. During the early Jurassic period, two major lineages of crocodiliforms began to diverge from each other. These were the Neosuchians, which include the common ancestors of all living crocodilians, and the highly diverse, mostly terrestrial Notosuchians. The latter were widespread across the southern continents, inhabiting a wide array of ecological niches, which included pig-like omnivores, blunt-snouted herbivores, and large hypercarnivorous forms that competed with theropod dinosaurs. Notosuchians possessed a suite of anatomical traits that were highly derived and unusual when compared to living crocodilians, with heterodont teeth that were often very similar to those of mammals. Most were also firmly terrestrial animals, with elongated limbs positioned directly beneath their bodies, a feature that was quite typical for Mesozoic Pseudosuchians, as we've seen in previous videos. Fossils belonging to Notosuchians are particularly well known from Cretaceous-aged South American rocks, with additional finds hailing from mainland Africa, Madagascar, and even Europe. Despite an estimated divergence point with Neosuchians stretching back to the early Jurassic, Notosuchian remains from this period are very rare, with the oldest known genus, Razanandrongobe, from the Middle Jurassic of Madagascar being the only known member of the group from this period. Prior to the discovery of this animal in 2006, it was thought that Notosuchians were a purely Cretaceous lineage. Interestingly, Razanandrongobe was among the most derived of all known Notosuchians despite its age, being the sister genus to the large carnivorous Cebecasuchians. This suggests that many of the Cretaceous groups possess long ghost lineages extending back into the Jurassic, with their fossils yet to be found. Hopefully, further insights into the early evolution of Notosuchians can be made in the near future. The most basal members of this clade first appear in the fossil record during the early Cretaceous in South America, mainland Africa, and Madagascar. These include the Uruguaysuchids, a family of modestly sized carnivorous animals comprised of three known genera. Uruguaysuchus itself was a relatively small terrestrial carnivore from Campanian and Maastrichtian age deposits of Uruguay, dating to between 83 and 65 million years ago. Measuring 1.2 meters or 3.9 feet long, this animal probably fed on small mammals and squamates in a semi-arid environment, living alongside titanosaurs, abelisaurids, and other Notosuchians. Its close relative, Araripesuchus, was a highly successful and widespread genus, with up to six known species that dwelt across Africa and South America from the early to late Cretaceous between 125 and 65 million years ago. A superficially dog-like animal, Araripesuchus was a slender, lightly built carnivore that measured between 1 and 1.8 meters long, with the different species ranging from fox to wolf-sized. This genus possessed a light coat of osteoderms running along the back, erect limbs and mammal-like teeth, complete with enlarged carnivores adapted for puncturing the flesh of small prey. The eyes were large, which may suggest a nocturnal or crepuscular fox-like hunting niche. One species, A. ratoides, also had a distinctive feature of highly enlarged and forward-pointing first dentary teeth, referred to as incisiforms, resembling the elongated incisors found in rodents. The generalized carnivorous habits of Araripesuchus likely contributed to its success, spreading across the then united Africa and South America during the early Cretaceous. A more unusual member of Uruguaysuchidae was the duck-snouted Anatosuchus, a small 70 cm or 2.3 feet long genus native to the early Albion of Niger roughly 100 million years ago. Possessing a broad, shovel-like skull and relatively simple conical teeth, Anatosuchus was possibly a specialized feeder of small aquatic prey, wading into the water like a heron in order to do so. Another basal Notosuchian family were the Peirosaurids, which were also relatively dog-like, but tended to be larger predators measuring up to 10 feet long. Members of this group also walked on semi-erect limbs, stalking the small elasmerian ornithopods and juvenile titanosaurs with which they shared their environments. Known from early to late Cretaceous fossil-bearing deposits in Africa and South America, Peirosaurids possessed taller and more robust skulls than the Uruguaysuchids, with slightly heterodont teeth suitable for slicing through flesh. Their jaws would have been powerful and capable of inflicting serious crushing bites to their unfortunate prey. Most genera so far described are native to Argentina and Brazil, with late Cretaceous forms such as Uberarasuchus being quite well studied. This carnivore measured up to 2.5 metres or 8.2 feet long and lived in an arid ecosystem alongside its close relative Peirosaurus, the titanosaur Aeolosaurus, and the dromaeosaur Ipupiara. A stocky, robust animal, Uberarasuchus would have somewhat resembled a Pseudosuchian honey badger, feeding on small prey in addition to the eggs and young of larger dinosaurs. With small predatory theropods being somewhat rare across former Gondwana when compared to contemporary environments in the Northern Hemisphere, Notosuchians seem to have had space to occupy moderately sized carnivorous niches here. Meanwhile, in the famous late Cretaceous Kemkem beds of Morocco, which have yielded the remains of enormous theropods such as Spinosaurus and Carcharodontosaurus, two Peirosaurids have been described, with these being Antosuchus and Hamadosuchus. These animals probably filled an ambush-hunting ecological niche, somewhat comparable to the eudromaeosaurs of Eurasia and North America, while preying on juvenile dinosaurs, lizards, and early snakes. An additional closely related family, being the sister group to the Peirosaurids, were the highly unusual Mahajangasuchids. Native to mainland Africa and Madagascar, these were the most massive of the basal Notosuchians, being capable of targeting relatively large prey. Only two genera are currently known, with the oldest being Kaprosuchus from the Cenomanian-aged Ekar formation of Niger and dated to approximately 95 million years ago. This animal is most famous for its large interlocking caniniform teeth, which resembled the tusks of a wild boar, which led to the genus name, which means boar crocodile. Measuring up to 6 metres or 19.7 feet long, Kaprosuchus was a possibly terrestrial carnivore that may have preyed on the relatively small titanosaur Nigersaurus, as well as juvenile individuals of Rebekisaurus, while the contemporary abelisaurid Rugops possibly competed with it for food. The snout of Kaprosuchus was elongated, with the tip of the snout reinforced with a keratinous shield that provided protection when ramming into prey. Its closest known relative was the Madagascan Mahajangasuchus, which lived during the Maastrichtian stage of the late Cretaceous between 70 and 66 million years ago. Going against typically terrestrial lifestyles of most Notosuchians, Mahajangasuchus was a semi-aquatic carnivore that superficially resembled modern crocodiles and alligators. Measuring up to 3 metres or about 10 feet long and weighing in the region of 790 pounds, this animal possessed a flattened and very robust skull, complete with stout, gripping teeth. The palate of Mahajangasuchus is similar to that of modern Neosuchians, which supports the idea that this morphology evolved to resist torsional forces during feeding. Potential prey would have included the noasaurid Mashikasaurus, the small herbivorous Notosuchian Simosuchus, and the Gondwanathere Vintana, which would have been caught by ambush at the riverside. Since Kaprosuchus is only known from a single skull, with no associated postcranial material, it is possible that it too may have been semi-aquatic, but at the moment this remains purely speculative. Despite the success of these basal Notosuchians, the KPG extinction event would bring their run to an end. Although containing an array of forms that range from small fox-like terrestrial carnivores to large semi-aquatic ambush predators, these basal forms only represent a tiny fraction of Notosuchian diversity. More derived members of this lineage would go on to experiment with herbivory, omnivory, and terrestrial hypercarnivory, although that is a story for another time. Thanks for watching, everyone. The next episode will cover the elephantoid proboscideans. So until then, I hope you enjoy the holiday season, and I'll see you again soon. Cheerio.